subscribe button below. And make sure you thumbs up this video. It helps my channel, and best of all, it's free. If you clicked on this video, you know that this is a story time of the worst trip I've ever had. This trip only happened about 2 days ago, and I said, let me hurry up and do a video so I don't lose any of the details of this story. The reason there was a trip made was because my children asked me, could they go to the beach? So I said, sure.
Let's go ahead and do this trip for the children. We're going to go to the beach.
I currently live in Maryland, and there's not really any beaches around. We have to drive about 2 hours out the way. We usually either go to Virginia Beach, which is my favorite, or we go to Ocean City. But Ocean City's not my favorite, so I wanted to do something that was different, but still kind of close, not too far. I found a beach called Rehoboth Beach. If you guys don't know where that is in Delaware. And it's somewhere near Ocean City, but it's about 30 minutes away from Ocean City. But Rehoboth is closer to us. So I said, okay, it's only 2 hours away, and this is gonna be different. I looked for hotels just in case we were to stay there. I find this hotel, I'm not gonna say the hotel's name, but basically I found the hotel and it is July, so most hotels are a lot of money or they're overbooked and you can't find a hotel. So I said, let me go ahead and do some research. So I find a hotel. It was only about, I paid about $100 for this hotel. So the hotel was $100. I said, oh wow, look at the pictures. They're so nice. They're actually on the beach and it's only $100. So obviously it was too good to be true. Now, what do they always say? When something's too good to be true, then it is. But I didn't listen to my intuition. I was excited. The pictures look great online. I called the hotel and I said, hey, are you guys on Rehoboth Beach? I'm just making sure because it says that you're actually on the beach. So they said, yes, whatever. We're on Rehoboth Beach. We're on the actual beach. So I said, fine. When you book your trip through, I think it was through Expedia.com or something like that, it says at the bottom, no refund. But I said, you know what? It's okay. This was the same day we were supposed to go there. Mind you, if you guys know me, if you're watching this and you know me, you know that I like to plan everything. Everything. I plan birthday parties. I plan trips. Try to plan births, okay? My own two births, but sometimes it doesn't work out that way. This was really big for me because I said, you know what, let's just live a little, but I will never do this again. I went ahead and I booked the hotel. Before we even got on the road, we went to Walmart. We get to Walmart. Okay? At this point, I have a huge headache, and I remember putting a pill of Motrin in my suitcase, but it was just one pill left. So I said, okay, when I get to wherever we get to, I'll just buy more. I tell my husband when we get to Walmart, you know what, don't get the pill that's in my suitcase. Just go ahead and get a whole new bottle. He gets the bottle, I take the pills. We're on our way, we have everything. So we thought, and this is gonna be a great trip. We get to, it was about 2 hours away from where we live. And the GPS is telling us to go straight. But it was a sign for Rehoboth to the left. We make a mistake and we go left because I'm thinking, okay, we're on Rehoboth Beach. Okay, so it's rerouting us. We're still driving about 30 minutes out of the way. We get to the hotel and I go in and I'm kind of looking at the hotel, but I'm like, I don't know, this just doesn't look right. I go in the hotel and of course, I ask, is this Rehoboth? You know, is Rehoboth Beach a whole 30 minutes away from where it said Rehoboth? She tells me no, Rehoboth is 30 minutes back the other way, and that this is Bethany Beach. Now, if you guys don't know, Bethany Beach is between Rehoboth Beach and Ocean City, and guess what she said? She said that Ocean City was a mile up the way. So basically, I could have went ahead and booked a hotel in Ocean City on the beach there. And this point, I'm like, okay, well, what's the difference between Bethany Beach and Ocean City and Rehoboth? She tells me the Bethany Beach just doesn't have the boardwalk. I said, okay, it's okay. We'll just go ahead and drive to Ocean City since it's a mile up the way. Let's just make the most of it. We get the key to the hotel. We go in the hotel room. You will not believe what I saw. I wish that I would have took pictures. We walked in the hotel room. Mind you, the way that the wording was online, I thought it was two beds. It said double occupancy. Because another room said something like two beds or something like that. So I just figured it was two beds. No, you walk in the room and it was one room. Like literally like a little bit bigger than probably your bathroom with one bed, one tube TV, a fly swatter that was broken in multiple places. Okay, a fly swatter, a pink fly swatter. The windows were tiny. They had brown chipped paint. I'm like, are we gonna get asbestos in this hotel room? I was so upset. It just looked dingy. It looked like the carpet hadn't been changed since the 1960s. It was horrible. But I said, you know what? It's okay. It's okay. I go in the bathroom. Oh my God, there was no bath. It was just a stand-up shower. And you know the silver thing that goes on your shower head that's against the wall? That was down and it was rusty. It was the most worst hotel I have ever stayed at in my life. The carpet was squishy in some places. It just felt nasty. Just imagine, there's a bed, a side table, a little teeny dresser with a TV with no remote, mind you, and then a little bathroom where the paint was chipping. My skin is actually itching right now because it just seems so dirty. Oh my God. But anyways, I said, it's okay. We're just gonna live. And my son, he's funny because he kept saying, let's just live, Mom, let's just live. I said, okay, let's just live. Let's go ahead to the beach, have some fun. Mind you, the suitcase had all of our clothes and everything, but I packed a separate bag, a beach bag, that had all of our beach things in it. We go ahead and get our stuff, we go to the beach. Mind you, I had my bathing suit on, my cover up, and then my kids also had just their bathing suits on. So we go to the beach, we're having fun, that was the best part. Flying kites, in the water, you know, I wasn't getting in too far, but I did have fun. We get to the hotel room, so I'm like, okay, this is a great amount of time that we can bathe, we can, you know, go to the boardwalk in Ocean City, we can still have a nice time, and then we can come back and get some sleep. I get in the hotel room, and I'm like, well, where's my suitcase? I can't find it. I go to the car, I can't find it. I go back into the hotel room, going back and forth. I ask my husband, where's the suitcase at? Nowhere to be found. He tells me, well, I thought you put it in the car. Y'all, when I tell you that I was so angry, like, I know that there was steam coming out of my ears. Oh my God, I was so angry. Like, you guys don't even know. I'm in a bathing suit. I have no underwear, no soap, just the hotel soap. I have no bra. I have nothing. All I have is flip-flops. I have nothing. I'm in sand and water and nothing else. That's it. No night clothes, no nothing. At that point, I said, okay, well, there's a Walmart 30 minutes up the way. On the way to Walmart, we find a TJ Maxx on the right-hand side. I wound up spending $80, over $80, just for night clothes for me and the kids. Had to get soap, lotion, toothbrushes, basically everything that you would have packed to go on a trip we had to buy. We get all that stuff. We go to the boardwalk. I'm like, oh wow, this bring me back up. This will bring my spirits back up. We get on the boardwalk at Ocean City. We're having a nice time. We will eat a large pizza. We get a funnel cake, and I got the first fried ice cream that I ever had. The ice cream was okay in the middle. You couldn't pick any flavors, so I had to get vanilla. But the batter on the outside was stale. It tasted like stale cornflakes with honey in it. Okay. Are you freaking kidding me? Which was $7.99. It was not cheap. Basically, I marked that off of my bucket list. We get back to the car, we go to the hotel. I walked in the hotel and I was like, you know what? I really don't even want to stay here. I could not even sit down. I can't even explain how I felt. Let's just go ahead and give the kids a shower because they do have sand all over them. And by the time we get home, they can just go ahead and get in the bed and go to sleep. And when I was about to give them a shower, I go in the TJ Maxx bag to get the soap. And guess what, guys? There's no soap. So I have no soap now. I was like, what else is going to happen? It was crazy. So we shook all of our stuff and made sure that nothing was in our stuff, like bugs or anything. And we got in the car, and when I went to the hotel tenant to give her the key, she had the nerve to say, well, why are you leaving? Did anything happen? And we finally got home at about 3 a.m. Guess what was sitting at the front door with the handles sitting straight up? My luggage. The moral of the story is to always go with your gut and always try to plan, because anything could go wrong. And never book a hotel the same exact day unless you absolutely know that it's nice and you've probably even been there before, okay? And always put your luggage in your car the night before. You guys have gotten this far in this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you like this video, just make sure you put the thumbs up, and that will let me know to do more story times like this. All right, guys, I'll see you next time. Bye.